I am continuing my reading. What I'm doing in this series is to read through the entire standard works of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. This consists of the Bible, the Book of Mormon, the Doctrine and Covenants, and the Pearl of Great Price. I am reading in a chronological order of events, not according to publication or volume, so I will be skipping around a bit as I move along. We are continuing again in Jeremiah. This will be chapter 30. In the last days, Judah and Israel shall be gathered to their own lands. David the king, meaning Christ, shall reign over them. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, Thus speaketh the Lord God of Israel, saying, Write thee all the words that I have spoken unto thee in a book. For lo, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel and Judah, saith the Lord. And I will cause them to return to the land that I gave to their fathers, and they shall possess it. And these are the words that the Lord spake concerning Israel and concerning Judah. For thus saith the Lord, We have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. Ask ye now, and see whether the man doth travail with child. Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. For it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off thy neck, and will burst thy bonds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves on him. But they shall serve the Lord their God, and David their king, whom I will raise up unto them. This is an interesting visual, an interesting description here, that the tribulations of the last days are so great, it is like men experiencing labor pains as a woman. I just don't know exactly what to say to that. But this is clearly talking about the last days. That day is great, you know, as Malachi would say later, the great and abominable day of the not the great and abominable day, but the great and dreadful day of the Lord. So this is clearly talking about the last days, and the people will be in severe distress. But let us continue. Verse 10. Therefore, fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, saith the Lord, neither be dismayed, O Israel, for lo, I will save thee from afar, and thy seed from the land of their captivity. And Jacob shall return, and shall be in rest, and be quiet, and none shall make him afraid. For I am with thee, saith the Lord, to save thee. Though I make a full end of all nations whither I have scattered thee, yet will I not make a full end of thee. But I will correct thee in measure, and will not leave thee altogether unpunished. For thus saith the Lord, Thy bruise is incurable, and thy wound is grievous. There is none to plead thy cause, that thou mayest be bound up. Thou hast no healing medicines. All thy lovers have forgotten thee. They seek thee not, for I have wounded thee with the wound of an enemy, with the chastisement of a cruel one, for the multitude of thine iniquity, because thy sins were increased. Why criest thou for thine affliction? Thy sorrow is incurable, for the multitude of thine iniquity, because thy sins were increased. I have done these things unto thee. Therefore all they that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thine adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity. And they that spoil thee shall be a spoil, and all that prey upon thee will I give for a prey. For I will restore health unto thee, and I will heal thee of thy wounds, saith the Lord, because they called thee an outcast, saying, This is Zion, whom no man seeketh after. Now this is a confusing mess, in my opinion. I will bring thee out of captivity, but you will not go unpunished. So, yes, I'm going to completely destroy all the other nations. You'll come out, but you're not going to go unpunished. And then this description, you'll be incurable. You have no healing medicines. Because of the multitude of thine iniquities, this has come upon you. It's kind of confusing. And thankfully, we have a Joseph Smith translation for these verses. So let us read that. This is verses 12 through 16, which we just read. So we'll read just the Joseph Smith translation here. For thus saith the Lord, Thy bruise is not incurable, although thy wounds are grievous. Is there none to plead thy cause, that thou mayest be bound up? Hast thou no healing medicines? Have all thy lovers forgotten thee? Do they not seek thee? For I have wounded thee with a wound of an enemy, with the chastisement of a cruel one, for the multitude of thine iniquity, because thy sins are increased. Why criest thou for thine affliction? Is thy sorrow incurable? It was for the multitude of thine iniquities, and because thy sins are increased, I have done these things unto thee. But all they that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thine adversaries, every one of them shall go into captivity. And they that spoil thee shall be a spoil, and they and all they that prey upon thee will I give for a prey. And then we have that last verse, that I will heal thee, I will restore health. So it's not saying that it's impossible for them to be healed. So yes, these are bad things, these are horrible things that you've been enduring, but the cure is possible, and I will bring it. I will restore you, I will heal your wounds, because your wounds, though being grievous, are not impossible to heal. They're not incurable. Makes a whole lot more sense. Verse 18. Let's finish the chapter now. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring again the captivity of Jacob's tents and have mercy on his dwelling places, and the city shall be builded upon her own heap, and the palace shall remain after the manner thereof. And out of them shall proceed thanksgiving, and the voice of them that make merry, and I will multiply them, and they shall not be few. I will also glorify them, and they shall not be small. Their children also shall be as aforetime, and their congregation shall be established before me, and I will punish all that oppress them. And their nobles shall be of themselves, and their governor shall proceed from the midst of them. And I will cause him to draw near, and he shall approach unto me. For who is this that engaged his heart to approach unto me, saith the Lord? And ye shall be my people, and I will be your God. Behold, the whirlwind of the Lord goeth forth with fury, a continuing whirlwind. It shall fall with pain upon the head of the wicked. The fierce anger of the Lord shall not return until he have done it, and until he have performed the intents of his heart. In the latter days ye shall consider it. So we haven't exactly stated here. It's in the latter days that all this happens. The Jews will be brought back. All Israel will be gathered again, and all their pain and suffering will be cured. And they will again be a great and independent people. Because as it says, their nobles will be from them, and their governor will be from their midst. They will no longer have foreign governors. They will be an independent and great nation. These are great promises to the house of Israel. And they are being fulfilled. We have the nation of Israel. It has not yet risen to its full greatness that God is describing here, but it has been established, and it is being preserved by God, and it will be preserved by God until it becomes the great nation that it is meant to be. We will leave that here. I think I have one more chapter in Jeremiah, then we turn to Ezekiel. So, see you there.